Hello and welcome to another video on how to use MobiLock to manage your devices. In this video, you would see how to enroll your Android device using a QR code. For the sake of demo, I have gone ahead and created a QR code configuration. QR code configurations can be created by clicking on device enrollment and QR code and using the create option. As you would see, I have created a QR code and associated a profile in that. I've also chosen a naming convention like this. Let's go ahead and now see what happens on the device. On the device, you can download the MobiLock Pro client from Google Play Store. And if you don't have Google Play Store, you can install using the MobiLock Pro APK. Once you launch the MobiLock Pro client, you would see the options to sign up and enroll. Let's go ahead and click on enroll. Once you click on enroll, click on QR code. Clicking on QR code would ask you for a couple of permissions. The first one is to take pictures and record video. Because we are going to scan a QR code, we require this permission. Click on allow. Clicking on allow would ask you for the permission to make and manage phone calls. Don't worry, we are not going to make any outgoing calls, but this permission is required to grab the IMEI number from the device. The IMEI number is shown to you as a part of device information. Click on allow, and once you click on allow, point the camera to the QR code on the dashboard. I've clicked on allow, I'm pointing it to the dashboard. If the QR code is valid, it will sign in and take you to the permission screen directly. Once on the permission screen, you would be asked a collection of permissions which are basic and mandatory. The first one is device admin. Click on the toggle next to each permission and you will be taken to a system screen. Click on activate to activate MobiLock as device admin. The subsequent permission is for usage access. Click on the toggle. You would be taken to the system screen. Click on MobiLock Pro and enable it. Hit the back key to navigate back to the permission screen. The overall idea of permission is to click on them and find MobiLock Pro in the list of apps and enable it. This would be true for all of the settings. As you have seen, I've just now enabled notifications. Similarly, enable unknown sources. Scroll down, click on overlay permission. Give the system settings permission. Once you have given all the permissions, you would see green ticks next to them and the next button would be enabled. Click on next. Now, these are the runtime permissions that are required so that MobiLock can perform optimally. Click on grant and you would see a set of system dialogs. Click on allow on each one of them to give all the permissions. Once you give them, the next button would be activated. Click on next. This is the final permission where you're setting up MobiLock as the default launcher. This would be shown because MobiLock is set up to run as kiosk. Click on setup MobiLock Pro. From the list, select MobiLock Pro and click on Always. Once that is done, you would see all the applications that I have allowed in the device profile. On the dashboard, you would see an EVA notification if EVA is enabled. If you go to the Devices section and refresh the Devices page, you would see the device appear here. Once you click on the device, you can see the device information. If you are looking to enroll your device using sign-in credentials or using the Android firmware work method, please refer to our other videos. Thank you.